Ladies and gentlemen, I am back, but better than that, I am a father. For the very first time, after 40 hours of labor, my wife, she's amazing, brought into this world little Harvey, our first child, our first son, and he is my everything. I've been spending the last couple weeks making sure they're okay, recovering well, and being brought into this world and trying to figure out this new thing of life as a father, and I just want to be so thankful for everyone in the academy who supported me along the way, who's, you know, given me this career where I have some flexibility to really focus on family. And I'm very grateful. I'm very happy. And I hope you guys appreciate why I've been away. But we just had the season 1.5 reloaded. I've taken some time. I've been grinding in game. And more importantly, I've been looking at the numbers. And this is one of the most important videos for you guys to watch, because I've seen some wild stuff on the timeline and on my YouTube videos of people recommending some crap classes, okay? So in today's video, I'm not only going to give you the best close-range weapons, I'm going to explain why. Because I hear a lot of, but what about, oh, you should try this? No, we're going to clear it all up in today's video with both stats, builds, and the gameplay as well. So without further ado, let's get into it. But first, do you guys remember DMZ? It was Call of Duty's attempt at an extraction looter shooter, but it completely missed the mark and unfortunately got shut down. And a lot of players have been looking for that experience just better executed. We'll bring in the sponsor of today's video, Arena Breakout, and they crush the mark. It is the best extraction looter shooter that I have played, and I have played a lot of them. Okay, it actually has that high risk, high reward, heart pounding action, but it also ticks the boxes of the military war simulator, where you have dozens of weapons throughout history, hundreds of attachments, and hundreds of missions to go along with it. In best off, it is free to play. And here's the crazy thing. I played it on stream and it is a free to play mobile game, but it looks like you're playing on console. This completely changes my mind on what mobile gaming is, because it looks incredible. And don't just take my word for it. It has 4.7 stars out of 5 on the Apple Store and tens of millions of players. It is incredible. Pick up your phone, pick up your iPad, and get involved in the brand new season 3 content. It adds more maps, more weapons, new bosses to take on, and you can go in solo or you can go in with a friend. And it has an amazing community that will both teach you how to play the game and join you in raid for some incredible free to play high adrenaline action. I don't get involved in a lot of mobile games, but I both played this and researched in it, and it is incredible. To try Arena Breakout for yourself, click on the link down in the pinned comment and the description to try out their new Season 3 Enter the Vault update. And a huge thank you again to them for sponsoring today's video. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the 10 best close range loadouts. And I know 10 kind of sounds like a nice number, but these are legitimately the only close range weapons I would touch. I'm seeing a lot of hype out there for some other stuff. We're going to cover some things that are broken that I probably should have saved for another video, because it's going to take over the meta. Once again, it's a glitch, but we're also going to cover what is going to be the long-term dominant meta, okay? And as you look at this first class, you can see the AMR and the HRM. Now, the HRM is the new SMG that just got dropped into the game, and then there's the AMR9 as well, which I used to never recommend, but after a series of buffs, it has gotten significantly better, and the stats are going to blow you away. Now, they have nerfed both the MTZ Interceptor into the ground, and they also nerfed the WSP Swarms mid to long range. It's still dominant close range, but after like 7 meters, man, the WSP Swarm is horrible. So I wouldn't recommend it anymore, simply because after that first drop off, you were getting chokeslammed by just about every gun in the game. WSP Swarm is pretty much dead. But let's go ahead and get into why I'm saying that. Now, this is the most important part of the video. Do not skip, because these stats are not only vital for your loadout, they're also vital for what ground loot you pick up across the map. I'm going to give you screenshots here in a moment, but it's so critical that you know the basis for why that I'm not just throwing out loadouts across Twitter or across YouTube just for the heck of it. There's a reason why I chose these loadouts, and I'm not wasting your time here. Make sure you understand why you trust an Iceman build over so many others, okay? So this is courtesy of True Game Data. The guy built out the entire site where he data mines the information from the game itself. He also does some manual testing on top of it. This is with the new update, 300 HP and a combination TTK of us hitting chest, arms, legs, so that way it's a consistent, because some guns have incredible TTK to the chest, but if you hit the legs, it just goes through the floor. So the baseline, the AMR and the HRM9. Let's compare that to the new WSP Swarm, which I still see so many of you running. Yes, there are times where that Swarm feels incredible. 605 milliseconds, the fastest killing SMG in the game. But after only 6 meters, 6 meters, that's like you running through a staircase in Vondel and pre-aiming and a guy being up at the top of the staircase. Like 6 meters is no distance at all. You are getting slammed because that time to kill goes up to 813. You compare that to any other game that is done, that is the difference between life and death. Okay, now I ran this against every other popular gun and just, there's a lot of lines here, but look at the common trend. The red and the orange line are the AMR and the HRM. Not only do they kill significantly faster at 0 meters, but especially when you get out to 20 to 30 meters, now we're talking about good sniper support, good mid-range support for an AR and LMG. Nothing comes close. The Hurricane, the Fennec, the ISO-9, the Lachman Sub, Vel 46, Bass P, Rival, the only ones that even come close, and they are viable options, we're gonna talk about in today's video, are the WSP-9, the Striker-9, and the Bass B. And we're gonna talk about the context for which we use them all, but as you can see, the fastest killing are still the AMR and the HMR, and the Bass B, but you have to keep in mind, it is it's a battle rifle, so it's not gonna be as fast. The Striker's decent, but it has a drop off at 10 meters. And one final thing that we're gonna talk about here in a moment, I want you to see it now, is as we compare these two guns, one thing that is important to keep in mind, even though the AMR looks like it's better, you have to keep in mind, the AMR's its worst feature is its sprint to fire. Its base sprint to fire is horrible. That's when we're sprinting and we try to get the gun down and shoot. They have addressed this and buffed it, but as we're building our AMR builds, we are building to help compensate for that, and this doesn't factor in attachments. If you want to go on a True Game Data site, you can actually go in and build out individual attachments. It's such an incredible tool. We're not going to get into that. You can try that out if you want. What we are going to get into is the work that I've already done to give you the perfect builds. Let's get into it. Build number one, the AMR sniper support, okay? I'm gonna shoot all of these with controller, with a hand cam, so you can see what it looks like for an actual person controlling this gun. We're gonna have both sniper support builds and CQC builds for the AMR-9. This gun is a lot of fun. Great movement speed, and it shoots very, very straight, and the benefit of it, of 10, 25, 50 meters, is that damage range drop-off doesn't quite hit like we're used to with the WSP Swarm. Okay, you can go into the gunsmith, you click on an attachment, you press L2, and then you can see that the effective damage range is 27 meters. You are killing as fast at 2 meters as you are at 27 meters. This gun is incredible. Now, what we've done is we've built it out to help out its ADS speed and its sprint to fire. Its sprint to fire being all the way down at 150 milliseconds is very, very impressive. So this is the build that we have rocking for a sniper support. Let's go ahead and get this hand cam out of the way. So as you can see here, we have the 50 round mag. The Phantom Grip is one of the best attachments I've ever seen for a rear grip because it helps out by 20% with your sprint to fire. The hand stop helps us out with our movement speed. And then I personally hate the iron sight on the AMR-9 because it's the circle and then the post. And then as you start to strafe, it starts to cover it up. Not for me. Okay, some people can rock with iron sights. I'm not one of them, and I try to make a build for the common man. I like a clean sight picture, and it is very, very easy to shoot. So make sure, if you guys are taking a screenshot right now, make sure you are subscribing to this video. Without further ado, let's get into the alternate option for a sniper support. So keep in mind, we got this sprint to fire down to 150 milliseconds on this AMR, so it's still very viable. But as we move over to the HRM, you will see we have it down to 105 milliseconds. So this gun is inherently a snappier gun to use, and it also has very clean iron sights. Okay, go ahead and take a look at these iron sights. It should remind you of the Grau. Now, I always purposely build out my weapons to have a bright neon sight so that way I can see very easily, and we can take advantage of that long, medium range sniper support capability and get insane time to kill at medium range, close range, and it moves really fast as well. Now for this, we are using the Jack BFB, which is a new muzzle that came into the game that helps out immensely. 60%, 20%, 40% with recoil. But this gun, you no longer show up as a dot, as you'll see in this video from JGod, you show up as a advanced UAV ping. Now some people see that as a disadvantage. For me, I don't. Because now players can't see my elevation, they can see my azimuth, what direction I'm facing, but for me, that dot, even if it stays longer on the mini map, allows me to hide my elevation, maybe also take some unsuppressed shots. And then as I'm finessing, people are still tunnel visioned on where that old red dot was. This Jack BFB allows you to shoot so many guns so dang straight. It's bringing guns into the meta that weren't meta before, because 60-20-40 is a lot of recoil mitigation. Now we're doing that because this gun's inherently a little bit shaky. Now we've built out the effective damage range longer with this longer barrel. We have the hand stop, which helps us move around a little bit faster. We have the 50 round drum mag. I understand there is a bug going on in the game right now. If you unlock this HRM9 early, there is a bug for some people where the 50 round drum isn't unlocking. The devs are aware of that. Hopefully that's been patched by the time this video has been posted, but just be aware of that. And then we're rocking the folding stock to help out with that recoil control. Keep in mind, this is a sniper support. So with an ADS of 250 milliseconds and a sprint to fire of 100 milliseconds, it's still very snappy. I feel very confident clearing out buildings with this gun. I actually won 4 games of solos in a row with this game. I almost went on a solo nuke without even trying. This is an incredible build. Tested, vetted. I absolutely love it. This is my sniper support. Make sure you're taking a screenshot. Now, let's say you don't need that mid-range support and you just want to get involved and clear out buildings. Well, we're going to take a look at the AMR built for close range combat. So it has the buffer tube on it, which is the equivalent of a nose stock, which allows it to have a much faster stray speed and an even faster sprint to fire, but it's still controllable and it still has that insane damage range out to mid-range. If you're shooting that with a WSP swarm, it would take like 60 bullets. Well, as we can see here, with this demo buffer tube, okay, it brings us down to 113 millisecond sprint to fire. When this gun first dropped inside of MW3, it had like a 300 millisecond. And they've continued to buff it. And now with all these new attachments and continual buff, the AMR is really in an amazing spot. We have the Phantom Grip, which we talked about earlier, Mark III Reflector, 50 round drum, and the DR6 hand stop for my movement AMR. Heading on to number 4, we have my movement HRM, and this gun would not be possible without the new Jack BFB muzzle because it has insane movement speed with no stock. I mean, you zoom across the map. You have great strafe speed as well. You have the clean iron sight, but we still have the long barrel, so we still have all that damage range. And as you can see, not even trying to control recoil that much, it shoots awfully straight. It's not going to be as straight as a sniper support, but the purpose of this gun, at least in this build, is to clear out the inside of buildings because we need something that if we're rocking an AR or an LMG, maybe a couple times a map, we'll need to switch to this because we ran out of ammo with our long range weapon. But the key battles are inside of 10 meters. And that's where, as we saw from the graph, this gun still fries. So getting into the build, we have the Jack BFB, which we need for that recoil control. We have the long barrel, we have the hand stop, we have the 50 round mag, and we have the no stock, and it's still controllable with a clean iron sight. This is probably going to be one of my go-to run and gun weapons. Make sure you're taking a screenshot. Heading on to number 5, okay, we have some new weapons that are starting to enter. That kind of taps out the long range for the AMR-HRM and the short range for the AMR-HRM. Now let's start to get into some other ones. So as we mentioned in the past, the Bass B, it's been a little bit shaky, a little bit tough to control, but with that Jack BFB muzzle, it now becomes a viable sniper support. And I bet you've never seen a Jack BFB shoot like that. And take a look at the hand cam, okay? As we can see, I'm hardly having the pull down. There's a little bit of left to right there that I wasn't anticipating, but with a little bit, and that's without me getting rotational aim assist, it's too much fun. And it reaches out to such insane ranges. And the fact that we can throw the no stock on there gives us that faster movement speed that we know and that we love from no stock builds. But we finally have the BFB to help control it. 60, 20, 40. From there, we have the DR6 hand stop, the 45 round mag, and the Mark III Reflector. Now, my only caveat is I would still probably opt for the other two sniper supports because they have faster reload speeds and faster sprint to fire speeds. But with that no stock build, we can start to get a little bit closer. You get about, if you can see right here, about a 200 meters per second sprint to fire, which means it's still going to be amazing at mid range, but clearing out buildings, I might want the HRM or the AMR in my hands, but still a very viable build. Make sure you're taking a screenshot. Heading on to weapon number 6. Okay, this is one of the weapons that we talked about. It is the Striker 9. This is going to kind of trump some of these guns in terms of mobility because even though it may not have the reach out potential of the other guns, it has the movement potential to make up for it, both for ADS strafe speed, both for sprint to fire speed, and time to kill is very, very practical. And it actually feels like a really nice SMG that we know and that we're used to using. So once again, we have the no stock Jack BFB combo, which we're used to. We have the 50 round drum mag. We have the recon barrel as well, which gives us more damage range. You can see the damage range drop off here is 12 meters as opposed to something like 18 or 20 plus with the HRM and the AMR. And then the Mark III reflector, because I'm not a fan of rocking the iron sights on this gun, but make sure you're taking a screenshot. As we mentioned earlier, the Striker 9 is still one of my go-to weapons for an SMG. If I had to rank them in terms of 1, 2, 3, it would be HRM, AMR, Striker 9, and then we'll get into it here in a second. It's the WSP 9, but there is something you need to be aware of.
Bruh.
You probably hate me pulling out this weapon. And if you haven't been on Twitter, if you haven't seen the murmurs of it, may not look like it here. Okay, but the firing range bots never do well with shotguns. This gun, indeed, is back with the double barrel. You can throw on the dual trigger, and it will result in it having a one-shot kill. So be very careful as you're going through Vondel. If you see someone carrying this weapon, they're more than likely going to try to stun, smoke, close the gap, and take you out. So we rock the Bryson choke, which is going to help us out with our shotgun spread. The barrel is going to help us out with our effective damage range. 3.6 is where the first damage drop-off is. The Bastion is going to help us out with our hip fire spread. And then the Heist stock mod is going to help us out, most importantly, with our sprint to fire. But I don't know how they accidentally added another one-shot shotgun to the game after just removing it a month ago, but it's here. Screenshot it and enjoy while you can. But let's get on to something that has not been patched, and it's been in the game for a very long time. This is what I believe a true shotgun should look like, okay? It is what I consider to be the MOG all the way from Blackout. It is the Lockwood, but it is the pump action version. And the nice thing is you can just strafe in and out of cover. So while it may not have the statistical time to kill of a normal SMG, the fact that you can take out your opponent's opportunity to get damage on target by strafing in, strafing in, strafing in. I've only shown myself for effectively maybe 200 milliseconds, but since I'm strafing and shooting, strafing and shooting, strafing and shooting, or as you can really get involved with the movement, this is so much fun to use, and you can, in good hands, smash any SMG in the game. I don't care who's rocking it with this build right here. So we go ahead, we have the Express Light Bolt, the X-Ray Skeleton, the Improved Choke, the Lockwood Defender, and the Sawed Off Mod. This is a little bit more of a high skill gun to use, but absolutely one of my favorite weapons to use inside of Warzone. If you guys like the builds, if you trust the builds that I have, a vast majority, surprisingly, of people who watch this channel are not subscribed. So make sure to take a moment right now. If you appreciate the stats that I've gone into, the fact that I'm building these guns as fast as I can, and more importantly, their quality, and I'm not piecing them out video by video on the main channel. You're getting a load of content right up front. Make sure to drop a subscription if you haven't already, because we are getting into our final builds. Okay. The WSP 9, as I mentioned, it is a very viable build, but I see too many people majorly gassing this gun up. I much rather would have the Striker 9, the HMR, or the AMR in my hand, but it still is a very, very viable weapon. Okay. It is the WSP 9, not the WSP Swarm. And as you can see, if you listen to that cadence, it has a slower fire rate than the WSP Swarm, but each individual bullet does a lot more damage. So a 50 round with the WSP 9 is going to do much more damage than a 50 round with the WSP Swarm, and it chunks. It hits pretty dang hard, okay? So let's go ahead and take a look at the build right here. And we have the Sonic Suppressor, the DR6 Handstop, the Short Light Barrel, and the Classic Factory Stock. This stock is insane for a stock, ladies and gentlemen. 9.22.30 is nuts for a stock. Like, there are very few attachments in the game that allow something to shoot that straight. Now, if you don't like the iron sights, you can get rid of the Sonic Suppressor, throw on something like a Slate Reflector, or me, I'm partial to the Mark III Reflector, but I think with that factory stock, it's a clean enough sight to look through. But man, if you throw on a sight on this gun, it's actually a lot of fun to use. I wouldn't consider it top meta, but definitely a worthwhile meta weapon to use, especially if you don't have the other ones leveled up. Now, before we get on to number 10, make sure you guys are subscribed here with notifications on, because we will be dropping the best long-range meta. And once again, there are some major misconceptions about what people are using. And when you get this gun early, you're going to be using it ahead of the rest of the curve, and you're going to really enjoy your game inside of Warzone. So make sure you are subscribed here for the long-range meta, which will be the next video that we drop. Without further ado, this one kind of shocked me. I threw it in here just for fun because I didn't realize this was a thing, but I'm starting to see more people running it. I've seen a lot more riot shields, and it's because for some reason The Karambit is a two-hit kill. This is like the Cali Sticks all the way back in Verdansk when people could 1-2 kill you. The Karambit now, instead of 250 HP back in Verdansk, 300 HP in the modern Warzone era. I don't know if it's a bug or what, but I was working my way inside of a building. I knew where a guy was. I'm like, oh, I'm going to slide in. I had the HRM in my hand. This guy's going to get absolutely slammed. I slide into the doorway and this guy is sitting right here and he just gets insane back-to-back lunge. Just knife, knife, dead. Faster than the fastest killing SMG in the game. Slammed. I slide canceled in. I did everything right. I had Peeker's advantage and he just, R2, dead. So, I'm sorry that I had to introduce you to that, but beware. Apparently the Tanfas do it as well. There are some melee weapons that are two hit. But ladies and gentlemen, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like on it. If you want me to review your gameplay or you want to check me breaking down my own gameplay as a coaching style of video, make sure to join me over on my second channel. That'll be linked in the pinned comment. All right, that'll be linked in the description as well. The third channel is where I take every single one of these guns. And I've put some hours into these guns, but maybe after I put a few days into them, I will start to refine an attachment here or there. The weapons over on the third channel are perfection, and they've also got some high kill gameplay to go along with it. But ladies and gentlemen, make sure to check out Arena Breakout if you haven't already. It's a free-to-play mobile game that blew away my expectations of a mobile game. Huge shout out to them for sponsoring today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed. It's good to be here. Good to be a father, and expect a lot more high caliber content coming from me. Make sure to drop a like on your way out, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.